हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू दिस यूट्यूब चैनल। टुडे वील गो क्रोनोलॉजिकली अबाउट हाउ वील गो अबाउट स्टडिंग हिस्ट्री फॉर UPSC, SSC एंड वेरियस अदर गवर्नमेंट एग्जाम्स। दिस इज ऑल्सो यूजफुल फॉर स्टूडेंट्स हु आर जनरली कीन एंड इंटरेस्टेड इन नोइंग अबाउट द हिस्ट्री ऑफ आर कंट्री। So how we'll go chronologically is, first we'll go for prehistory. This prehistory comes under ancient India here we study prehistory. It is divided into these five categories: Paleolithic, Mesolithic, Neolithic, Chalcolithic and Megalithic. After prehistory comes Indus Valley Civilization. The period of Indus Valley Civilization is 2500 BC to 1750 BC. Indus Valley Civilization is also known as the first urbanization in India. So next comes the Vedic Age. Vedic Age is from 1500 BC to 600 BC. Vedic Age is divided into two, which is the early Vedic Age and the later Vedic Age. This early Vedic Age is from 1500 to 1000 BC. And the later Vedic Age is from 1000 to 600 BC. After this comes pre-Maurya period. This lasts from 600 BC to 300 BC. Then comes the Mauryan Empire. In Mauryan Empire, it is from 300 BC to 200 BC. In this, we study about kings like Chandragupta Maurya, Bindusara, Ashoka, about the great Chanakya, inscriptions of Ashoka, foreign invasions and many others. After comes post-modern period. This is from 200 BC to 300 AD, which means about 500 years. After that comes the Gupta Age. Gupta Age is very famous for political history and it is also called as the Golden Age. Now Gupta Age has two phases. First phase is the growing phase, in which the architecture and all those things were growing, and then comes the declining age. In further chapters, we'll know in detail why all this happened. After this comes post-Gupta Age, which is from 550 AD to 750 AD. What happened in this is that the central authority declined, and the last king was the King Harsha. So after ancient, we'll read about medieval India. In medieval India, first we learn about the early medieval India, in which we'll learn about feudalism, about all the foreign invasions, Arab annexations, annexations by the invasions of Muhammad Ghazni, about Muhammad Ghori. We'll read about all this, and then we'll read about Delhi Sultanate is very important part in medieval history, very important. In this, we'll read about chronologically how the kings came. First came Tilbari dynasty. Then came Khalji डायनेस्टी, देन केम तुगलक डायनेस्टी, देन केम सैयद डायनेस्टी एंड देन केम लोधी डायनेस्टी. ओके, वी विल रीड अबाउट ऑल ऑफ दीज डायनेस्टीज एंड ऑल ऑफ दीज किंग्स अंडर दीज डायनेस्टीज, हाउ वन ओवरथ्रू द अदर एंड केम इन टू पावर. After Delhi Sultanate, we'll read about the Mughal Empire. You know all the chronology. First Babur came, then Humayun, then Akbar, Jahangir, Shah Jahan, Aurangzeb, and then the later Mughals. Okay, so we'll read about all of this, all of the kings in detail. What was the architecture during their time? What was all the wars that were conducted? And the last topic would be Maratha rise within the medieval India. After medieval India, we'll go on to modern India. This is the most important topic. In all, in this topic, what will be the broad topics? British foundation expansion and consolidation. Next would be British policies. Next would be the revolts and movements, like the very famous revolt of 1857. Next will be Indian national movements. In 1885, the Indian National Congress was found, and in 1947, we got freedom. So within all that span, all the national movements, all the freedom struggle that happened, will come under this topic. This is a very important topic. Then we'll read about communalism and the partition of Bengal, the partition of with Pakistan, and then we'll read about post-independence. What happened after we gained independence? So after that, we'll be completed with Indian history, the entire Indian history. Then we'll move on to our world history. We'll divide world history into three broad categories. Okay, first category would consist of revolutions like the Industrial Revolution, the American Revolution, the Russian Revolution, French Revolution, in which we'll read about Napoleon, and we'll read about imperialism and colonialism, like we were also colonies of the Britishers in that way. In next group, we'll read about Napoleon, then the famous Metternich system, the European Revolution, how the Germany was unified, how Italy was unified, and the famous Bismarck foreign policy. Then in the next group, we'll read about very important the First World War, which was from 1914 to 1919. Then what happened between the First World War and the Second World War, and after that we'll read about Second World War, which was from 1939 to 1945. And then finally, we'll read about the Cold War, which started 1945 onwards. So this was an overview about how we'll proceed. You can jump to specific topics if you want to. You can also focus on the areas that you need the most attention. I have compiled these notes and these study material from various sources. I have used NCERT and some other reference books like Spectrum, Bipin Chandra, etc. I hope you will continue going through these lessons and you are able to clearly understand and grasp the concepts. If there is something which you don't understand, or some subjects or some topics in which you need more clarity or more in-depth analysis, then please mention below the comment section. Also, if you find these videos useful, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you for watching.